People of Earth, it is I, Henry, from Monkeyvania. That's right. All right. All right. Thank you. That's enough. Calm down. Come on. It's starting to sound a little bit insincere. Hey, hey, it's a great day for America, everybody. I tell you what, how about that Barack Obama, eh? And what about that John McCain, eh? What about them? This Earth comedy is more complicated than it seems. Don't you just say the names and people go, ah! Let's try again. Hey, how about Rush Limbaugh? He's fat, isn't he, everyone? Ah! Yes, he is. I see. On my planet, humor is based entirely on bananas. The reason I have returned is because I can. And I have news. Soon, the ships will arrive from my planet, bringing more and more cheeky, lovely, cute little monkeys. We will, scurry up your beaches. You must ask yourself this question. Would the CBS censor bastards, would they censor someone as adorable as me? I don't know. We'll probably find out later. We'll be right back with proper television.
Now, shh, quietly, please. You're scaring me. It's almost as if I'd been naughty. And you were shouting at me and maybe pulling my hair a little bit. Perhaps I've said too much. Oh, it's a great day for America, everybody. You know why? It's Friday! Thank goodness! You know, I'm a bit sniffly and stuff. I'm like... So I'm glad it's Friday because I've got the weekend to relax and enjoy being ill. I don't know if it's good to be ill at the weekend and then and not take any time off work or to take time off work and be ill. Now, don't you shake your head at me. Anyway, it's Friday, everybody. The first presidential debate was tonight, of course. And wasn't it great? You know, it got me thinking. I was like, yeah, you make a good point, but you also make a good point. You know who I think won, though, really, honestly? Whichever candidate you support. I agree with you, America. Take that, controversial talk show hosts with your opinions about things. It's been a very odd week. You know, Barack Obama, you know, of course, is still on the campaign trail with all of his family. Michelle Obama says that she keeps the kids entertained by throwing slumber parties, which coincidentally is how Bill Clinton kept himself entertained during his campaign. So it all comes full circle. Did you see that David Blaine stunt this week? Oh, come on! That is such crap, that stuff. I hate it. Apparently, the exciting conclusion of the stunt, you know, hanging upside down for a long time. Oh, take that, Evel Knievel, jumping Snake River Canyon on a rocket. Anyway, the conclusion of the stunt was interrupted by President Bush's live speech. And it's the first time in a long time the president's approval ratings went up. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. President. That's what you call improving your legacy. The weirdest story that I saw this week, though, there was a guy in Kentucky, a man in Kentucky, that claims his genitals were removed without his consent during a routine operation. Like, can you imagine? I mean, when you wake up and go, now, you did a great, but like, what? And, you know, he said to them, because he's mad, and can you blame him? And when he said to them, when did I agree to this? Actually, he probably said it more like, that's terrible, though, isn't it? Come on, it's terrible. It's very upsetting, I'm sure. It's deep things. Anyway, it's Friday. It's a big movie day today. You know the movie that's opening today? I'm very excited about. It's Knights and Rodanthe. Knights and Rodanthe. I think it's Rodanthe, or is it Rodanthe? I don't know. It's one of those romance movies anyway. I don't know what Rodanthe is. I think it's that stuff that helps you grow the hair. You shampoo it in. Shampoo in the Rodanthe and reap the benefits. Hi, Stacey, want to come over? No, Rodanthe is a real place. It's in North Carolina. Do we have a map of North Carolina? There it is, North Carolina there. Carolina, Blueberry Hill. Cape Fear. Yeah, all that. That's all there, yeah. Now, this movie, Knights and Rodanthe, it's not a movie for guys. There's no car chases. There's no explosions. There's no naked boobies. There's no skeletons riding motorcycles on fire, which is the greatest movie I've ever seen in my life. God, I love that movie. You ever seen Ghost Rider? If you haven't seen Ghost Rider, go and join Al-Qaeda. Love that movie. Anyway, the Knights and Rodanthe, it's a film for ladies. You know, it's romantic. You know, for people that like the romantic films, you know, they like eye contact during sex, all that stuff, you know. Yeah, no. There aren't that many good. Wait, no, it's like that. Do you know what it's like when the dog humps your leg, which is kind of embarrassing, but what's worse is that it kind of has that disinterested look on its face. Like, the dog's humping your leg and it's kind of going... You're like, can you at least, you know, fake a smile or something? And like, Ruby-Ruby-Doo! Anyway, Knights and Rodanthe, it's a romantic movie. There aren't that many good romantic movies. A couple of years ago, someone asked Bill Clinton his favourite romantic movie, and he said The English Patient, which I hated that movie. It combines two of my least favourite things, English people and patience, right there. I also don't believe that is Clinton's favourite movie. What about Casablanca? Or The Big Lewinsky? What about that? Yeah, that's right. We're so topical, we're doing three elections ago. Is that two elections ago? I don't know. Anyway, Knights and Rodanthe, it's supposed to be very romantic. You get Richard Gere and Diane Lane. Oh, yeah. Wake me off a piece of that. And Diane Lane's not bad either. I'm sure the movie is about, you know, lovely candlelit dinners, long walks on the beach, men who say... Let's talk about our relationship, honey. Can I be honest, ladies? The only men who like talking about relationships are men who are in relationships with other men. We'll do it, but we don't like it. Just say. Do you know, the movie actually sounds like it's made from a personal ad. You know, single white female wants to share love and 15 adorable cats. In search of a handsome rich man who loves sunsets and the smell of cat pee. When the women... Because when women write... You see in that personal ad, when a woman writes an ad, it's all like, looking for love and interest and conversation, friends, maybe going on to something else. Lovely kind of thing. So maybe something will unfold in our genuine love of tapestries. And men write a personal ad, it's like, seeking discreet encounter. Available between 1 o'clock and 2 o'clock on Thursdays. Looking for a chick between 21 and 22, no pets. Waiting by the phone.
Not every guy's like that, of course. No, no. In the Knights of Rodanthe movie, he's got Richard Gere's in it. He's lovely. He loves pets. I read that on the internet. He loves animals. I read that on... I'm not going there.
feeling sniffly and it's Friday. I've had a very hard week. Not as hard as having my genitals cut off without my consent, but it's been tough.
Man, I can't get that image out of my head. What the hell do you say if you're the doctor?
Well, good news is you're alive. Now, something happened during the surgery. How can I put this?
Do you recognize these?
All right. We have to take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. Welcome back to the big Friday night show where I'm looking forward to the weekend where I can be ill on my own time and not CBS's time because they pay me so much money that I can't be ill, apparently. I've got a fever right now. A fever for you. I can't be mucking around flirting with you. Do we have time for an email tonight? Do we have time?
Yes, it's email time again.
Put down your ganja, it's time to check the mail.
Yeah, man. You can think so. All right, this is from Christopher in Fairhaven in Vermont. Vermont is French. It's French. It's not French. I mean, it's obviously it's American, but it's the name Vermont is from the French Vermont, Green Mountain. That's what it means. Yep. Anyway, Christopher says, "Dear Craig, do you ever not feel like preparing material for the show and just winging it instead?" No, I believe in rehearsed, rehearse the comedy, have it written down, strict. I run a tight ship here. This is from Frank in Mesquite, Texas. Mesquite, is that where the bricks come from? They make these little mesquite bricks and you put them on a barbecue and your food smells adorable. Can food smell adorable? You know what I mean? It smells good. You want to taste it, mesquite, and then it tastes all kind of smoky, like Smokey and the Bandit. Luckily, we prepared that earlier, that material. When I say material, I just mean, a guy talking crap for a while. I'm like the David Blaine of late night television. I just I just turn up and like do something and hope people will give you some cash. Anyway, Frank in Mesquite, Texas says, "Have you ever found any buried treasure while you were scuba diving?" You know, I haven't while I was scuba diving. But I have found buried treasure. In my pants. You call it what you like. I call it treasure. Listen, it's all I got. Hey, listen, at least I still have it. It could be gone. It could be gone. I can't get that out of my head. Maybe the doctor should say, "Well, the good news is you're going to be rich." There. You wake up, doctor says, "You're going to be rich." A lot of money coming your way. All right, now, do you enjoy the celebrity gossip? Me neither. I love it, I mean. So many celebrity gossip shows are on TV these days. I love them all, but this one is my favorite. Take a look at this.
It's Access Extra-tainment tonight.
Good night. I am Bonnie Slash.
And I'm John Tesh.
Tonight we look at a disturbing trend that's taken over Hollywood. It's called getting married. Marriage. Why do people do it? In Hollywood, it's usually because they're drunk.
Or because they're trying to look normal.
Or because they're Larry King. This year, some of Hollywood's hottest stars have tied the knot. Jessica Alba, Ashley Simpson, Lisa Simpson.
In January, Eddie Murphy was married for 2 weeks.
Yes, but he found out the shocking truth. She's a woman.
But But not all Hollywood marriages end quickly.
No, they don't. You're right. History shows that marriages can last for months.
Like Nicolas Cage and Lisa Marie Presley.
Pam Anderson and Kid Rock.
Drew Barrymore and Tom Green.
David Guest and Liza Minnelli.
Rumor has it, Brad and Angelina are getting married soon.
Brangelina's wedding will be attended by their whole family. Knox, Vivienne, Shiloh, Maddox, Tommy, Corky, Pinky, Trevor, Scooter, Blonky, Spuds, Goober, Dingo, Flopsy, Gary, Pee-Pee, and Regis.
And now, in California, gay marriage is finally legal.
Good news for Rosie, Ellen, and Ryan Seacrest. Wait a minute. What? Why did you say finally legal?
No reason.
Are you a gay?
None of your business.
That means yes.
Okay, so what now?
Fiddleline.
How so?
Well, it doesn't work much, but when it does,
it's bloody awful. Hey, hey. Until next time, I'm Bonnie Slash.
And I'm John Tesh.
Good guy, good day. The thing that I'm doing this week, it's the start of the fall season on television, so all the trailers are playing on TV of all the actors from the shows doing this. It's awesome. It's my favourite time of year. Take that, Christmas, with your fun. Hey, my first guest tonight is an old friend of mine, and when I say that, I'm lying, of course, it's show business, but I... No, he's an old friend of mine, and he's the host of the Price is Right. Please welcome America's sweetheart, Drew Carey, everybody. Drew Carey.
Here's what the doctor said when he accidentally removed the guy's genitals.
He looked Did you say tentacles? You said tentacles.
Genitals.
Oh, genitals.
Yeah,
okay.
He looked at his chart and he went, oh, coccyx. He went, oh, balls of your feet.
Oh, oh. All right. All right, yeah, yeah.
Oh, tibula.
Believe that story? Can you imagine?
I believe it.
That's horrifying to me. Yeah. How are you? You look well.
Oh, you wanted to get your teeth cleaned. So sorry.
So I thought teeth clean meant cut your off. Yeah. I had no idea. No, they teach you that. It's first day at medical school. For goodness sake, if you find yourself hacking someone's genitals off, double check the order sheet just in case.
Yeah.
First day.
Yeah, ask the nurse.
How are you?
I'm doing great.
Yeah, how's the Price is Right doing? Are you having fun?
Doing real well, yeah. We torture the host, the announcer this year.
You tortured him?
That's my new thing. Yeah, we're getting Rich Fields as the announcer, and I think he's been in the booth too long, so we decided to, during the showcases to bring him out of the booth.
Does he like it? Doesn't like it?
He loves it. He loves the attention. Can we show our little clip?
Yeah, go on.
Get that first clip.
Here's your showcase. First, Antonia from Teleflora. It's a year's supply of flowers. Teleflora offers the best choice in floral arrangements using only the freshest flowers, always hand-arranged and hand-delivered in exquisite vases by a neighborhood florist. You'll receive one beautiful arrangement per month for a year from Teleflora. Next, a new video arcade game. A 3-in-1 arcade game featuring the classic games of Donkey Kong, Donkey Kong Jr., and Mario Brothers. Enjoy groovy game playing with these timeless classics. Well, you're inhaling. All right, here we go.
And finally, it's two Harley Davidson XL 883 custom Sportster motorcycles. Each with an air-cooled engine, chrome lace front wheel, and forward-mounted foot controls. And this showcase featuring flowers for a year, a new video arcade game, and two Harley Davidson motorcycles can be yours if the price is right.
Yeah.
See, now that's why you do well in this country. That's a great show. You got a hot-looking girl and a couple of great motorcycles and a guy inhaling helium.
Yeah,
there's no more entertainment
else.
Possible.
You don't need anything else. We've been doing, like, we had him, I don't spoil the show, we had him come out in a, you know, I get him come out in a dress the other day, you know, just because we could.
All the time here.
Yeah. On the Drew Carey show, that was like
Drew Carey show, we were doing that all the time. Well, Mr. White was always in a dress. Oh, well, let me just...
Yeah, you know,
just...
actually, you know, I was watching your Entertainment Tonight thing.
Oh, and, yes.
We actually got married for a season.
On the Drew Carey show, that's right. You and I. Can I just say it, by the way? I haven't said it for a long time. Carey, you're fired.
Oh. Yeah.
That's nice, isn't it? It's nice. It's got a nice ring about it, hasn't it?
It's nice. So, do you have Tony Parker's going to be on the
yes,
show later?
Yes, he is. Yeah, yeah. You're a big fan of the NBA, are you?
Yeah, well, I went to the, you know, the Spurs beat the Cavaliers last year in the NBA.
Yes, you did.
So, I was at the last game. And first of all, I was the last couple games in Cleveland. And, first of all, I saw the Spurs, you know, warming up, and I guess a couple of them recognized me, the coach. They like, waved, and I yelled out, should have been Phoenix! Should have been Phoenix! And then...
Great, they must have rushed over embrace you.
And then at the end of the game, so I'm in Cleveland. I'm, you know, known for being from Cleveland. I'm at the NBA Finals. We're losing. And I'm in a rich guy section in the
arena. It's because you're a rich guy.
Because I'm a rich guy.
Yeah.
And there's a guy behind me, and he tells everybody in the section that he's all nervous. I go, what's wrong? And he says he's got $75,000 on the over. So if it goes over a certain total, both the scores of each team, if it goes over a certain total, he wins $70,000.
Good Lord.
And
is that legal?
Yeah. No.
Okay.
No, it's not legal. No.
But rich guys can do it anyway, because who gives a crap?
We can kill people.
So it's much like Wall Street is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Right, okay.
Exactly like
Wall Street, yeah.
And then the thing is, if you lose your $70,000, the government will bail you out.
Yeah, that's right. There you are. There's your check.
Yeah.
That drives me crazy. That drives me mad, that stuff.
With no oversight. Yeah, I know. It's a big power grab.
You know, $3,600 for every taxpayer in America to bail these people out.
Yeah, I think, honestly, the Republicans have gone crazy. They just want, you know, no oversight. They want all the money. Honestly, they're crazy.
Yeah, I know. I thought you were a Republican, aren't you a Republican?
No,
no.
Libertarian, mostly.
All right. Was that a librarian?
That's the same thing. Libertarians are like conservatives that still get high.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Yeah, that is exactly what you are. Yeah. Hey, do you still go up to Vegas all the time? Do you do all that? You still
go? Yeah, so I'm going this weekend,
talking of getting high, and did you up there and you get out of your mind crazy? Because now you're not just on the show, you're the weekly show. You know, you've got the prices right. You have some standards to uphold. You can't just be going nuts and going to strip clubs in Vegas anymore.
No, I have a fiance, too, and a three-year-old.
Oh, yeah, that'll stop you.
Yeah, that'll stop me.
Absolutely. So you're going to see Knights and Rodans then this weekend?
No.
You can wear one of your dresses, maybe.
No. I can wear Richfield's dress when I go to see Knights and Rodans. No, I'm going to go. We're going to go see Barry Manilow.
You really are getting married, yeah. aren't you? Good God.
But that's good. Barry's great. He's been on his show. He's a great guy. He's a professional entertainer. He'll do the thing for
you.
Yeah,
his show opens on Friday, tonight, or this weekend in Las Vegas. And he can't smile without me, so yeah. I have to be there.
You know what, though? He doesn't actually write the songs.
No.
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 He says he writes them. He writes some of them, but that song, I Write the Songs, he didn't write that
That's
one.
That's the scandal of Barry Manilow.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what we should do someday? Because I know you play piano and drums. We should get together for charity events, and we should form a band and call it Barely Manilow.
Okay, I'm with you, right?
And you play the music, and I'll sing the Barry Manilow songs.
Wait. I'll sing the Barry Manilow songs.
I'll play the
You still play the keyboard and stuff, don't you?
I play accordion as good as I did in third grade.
You were pretty good at the accordion, as I remember.
No.
I was not bad at it.
Well, that's because you don't see that many accordion
players. Well, so you were my boss at the time, so I was like, oh, yeah, you're great at that.
Yeah.
Woo, hey.
If I was on here, unknown, auditioning with my accordion, you'd have me booted out to...
No.
You'd kick me so hard, I'd land in the Grove.
No, not so. Not so. I'm telling you, we have so much hours of television to fill every night. If you turn up with an accordion, you're on. First guest.
So are you telling me that if one day I take the... I take the elevator up and I'm right here.
Right.
I'm 60 seconds away from the stage.
Yeah.
So if one day I come up with my accordion and just walk out here, I can come out anytime.
Anytime you like. Absolutely anytime. Absolutely no problem with that.
It's very tempting.
Yeah, I'm telling you, anytime you have a platform here to further
can't
the cause
smile
of
smile without you. Can't smile without you.
You know, you should get going when you see Barry with your fiance, Nicole. It's Nicole.
Yes,
that would be awkward if you weren't and I suddenly said that. Well, yeah.
Very.
It would be like trying to tell Nicole would be the same as that guy telling the guy he'd cut his genitals off. It's well, there's good news and bad news.
Yeah.
Please. Actually, there's no good news, just bad news.
Craig, her name's Champagne.
Oh, yeah, Champagne. Right. It's not Champagne.
Sorry.
She'll kill you.
No, I know.
I know. So, we're done.
Yeah. Those are all my stories. Oh, you know, I got to do the coolest thing, too. I got to be the guy that yells out at the NASCAR race, the beginning of the NASCAR race.
Did you really start your engines?
The Pepsi 500, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, we have a clip of that too. It was really.
What do you mean bringing clips? Never mind bringing damn clips. Where's the accordion?
I got clips.
All right, roll the clip. Drew Carey, everybody. Where are you at?
Famous words in motorsports. Please welcome your Grand Marshal, host of The Price is Right, Drew Carey and The Price is Right Models. Gentlemen!
Welcome back, everybody. Do you know what? I miss Drew. I used to see Drew all the time. I used to see Drew Carey all the time. And do you know what? It's interesting. You know, people think they know Drew. They think, oh, Drew, he's just a big guy that likes fried food and strippers. And he is. He's lovely. My next guest is a basketball superstar. Oh, yeah. 3 NBA championship titles with the San Antonio Spurs. He's the cover athlete. The cover athlete? What does that actually mean, a cover athlete? On the box. He's cover athlete on the box. Yeah, well, now I know then. He's the cover athlete on the box. Oh, on the box for the video game. Oh, wait there. That's him. He's on the box. NBA Live 09 in stores October the 7th. Tony Parker, everybody. Tony, welcome, Tony. I didn't know what a cover athlete was. I thought it was some NBA term for someone who covered something.
I have no idea.
No, it's not. No, it's not that. But you're the cover athlete on the box. Look.
Yeah. See my big muscles.
I see your big muscles. Yeah. Are they really that big?
Actually, it's only the head who looks like me. If not, it's another body. I think. I'm not that strong. That was Eva's dream to have big arms like that. But I don't have big arms like that.
You've got pretty big arms. You're a basketball player. Eva's been here, you know. She's nice. I liked her. You probably like her too.
A little bit. A little bit.
Everybody keeps talking about her being pregnant. Is she pregnant?
No.
Okay.
No. I promise you, when she's pregnant, I will tell you. I promise you. We don't want to hide it. I don't know why people keep asking us.
It's weird, I think, that people keep speculating about it. But please tell me first.
I will. Just have to give me your number and I'll call you.
Okay.
I'll call you.
All right, well, you may want to check that with Eva first. Now, tell me about where you're from, because I don't think you're originally from San Antonio, are you?
No, not at all. I've never been to San Antonio before I went for basketball, before I got drafted. And I'm like international. I'm born in Belgium, and my mom is Dutch, and my dad is American.
Wow.
But I'm French.
You're like the international house of pancakes in
one guy. Yes, almost.
But Belgium is the Canada of France, basically. Yeah. But that's
No, you're right. We make fun of them. But I only stayed over there 3 weeks, so, you know.
Right. You only stayed there 3 weeks?
They think I'm, like, from Belgium, but I always say, no, I'm from France.
All right. Which part of France did you grow up in then?
Paris.
Oh, very nice. Which part of Paris?
16, Boulogne.
I don't think I know the 16th. I know the 7th.
Yes, you know. No, 16 is where all, you know.
Oh, no, that's the fancy part with the Eiffel Tower
and everything.
Yeah. Are you from a very wealthy family?
No, not at all.
Oh, really? So you were just in the 16th helping?
I was. I will put it like this.
Yeah, all right. So moving to the United States from France to play basketball, I didn't think the French were really big on basketball, to be honest.
Are we not?
Oh, right.
No, we're better in soccer. But yeah. Because my dad was American, every summer we went to Chicago. And so I was a big fan of Michael Jordan.
Oh,
so.
Did you see the Bulls play in Chicago?
Yes.
You'd be too young for that, wouldn't
you? I was 14 when I saw them play.
Wow. Michael Jordan, have you met him?
Yes.
Really?
Of course.
That must be amazing for a basketball player.
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah?
It was great. The first time I met him, I was like shaking and everything.
Yeah,
I was like my idol.
What does he smell like?
I can't help you on that.
Yeah.
I can't help you.
I'm just always intrigued. I mean, once he's, you know...
Why the smell?
I just thought it might be interesting to know. I mean, if he smelled odd, like, you know, maybe smelled a bit like, you know, soup or something, you would go... Here's an odd fact about Michael Jordan that most people don't know. He smells a bit like soup. And everyone would go, whoa, really?
No, I can't start that rumor. I can't start it.
Right. No. Let's start that rumor. Why not? Let's start a rumor. You know, because I heard he smells like soup. He actually does. That's why I started talking like this. Are you a United States citizen yet?
Yes, I got both passports.
Yeah. Congratulations. Well done. Did you have to sit the test?
You have what?
Did you sit the test? The
No, but my dad is American, so I got
automatically.
Oh, yeah,
you get in because of that. Yeah.
So I didn't pass any test.
Yeah.
He just gave it to me.
I had to sit a test.
Really?
Yeah.
It was hard.
It was hard.
No. Did they ask you how you smell?
Yeah, they said... How do you smell? Well, the thing is, you have to go. So they already know how you smell because you're in the room, so they check. To see if you're a truthful person. You know, you go in, you smell a bit like biscuits, and they say, how do you smell? And you say, biscuits. And they go, I see you're honest. Welcome to America. And then you go. I seem to remember it was something like that. Well, now, do you go back to Paris a lot? Do you spend a lot of time there?
I just came back from Paris.
Really?
Yeah, I was doing an EA Sport event, same thing for the game.
October
7th, like that, they're happy, you know, October 7th.
Yeah.
That was my only phrase I had to say, October 7th.
October 7th?
Yes.
All right.
So I just came back just for you. Just for you, I came back.
Really?
Yes.
Tony, thank you so much. You mean you didn't come back to see your lovely wife?
That too.
Yes, I came back for her. Tony Parker, everybody, we'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. Now, my next guests are on the cover of this, you know, they got the CD here. They're very attractive. They're very attractive. I'm not talking a little bit attractive. I mean, these people are gorgeous. Look at them. I mean, come on, that's like one of them Abercrombie and Fitch things. What do you call them? You know, the Abercrombie. You know, the store in the mall where all the people that work there are too beautiful to help you. That store. Anyway, these people are very good looking. They're here performing, looking for a good time from their self-titled debut album. Please, everybody welcome Lady Antebellum, everybody. Lady Antebellum.
just looking for a good time. Looking for a good time.
Usually put that kitten on a Friday night because sometimes when the kids are watching the shows on a Friday night, they enjoy the herbal cigarettes and they like a little psychedelia. You know. Psychedelia apparently for me involves using jazz hands. Psychedelia. Psychedelia. It's the kind of delia I like. Oh, man, I'm such a... Actually, I'm not allowed to say that word, am I? That's what always baffles me, because Conan says that word all the time. And I'm not allowed to say it. Why? We're on at the same time. There's a question you might want to ask your senator. Next time you get anywhere near a member of government, say, how come Conan can say a word that Craig can't, and they're on at the same time? Doesn't seem fair to me. You know why? It's because I wasn't born here. Don't you start. I don't even know what I mean by that. Anyway, that's what we learned. And I think I'm taking a moment of gratitude tonight to be grateful that I still have my genitals. Good night, everybody.